I really want to get certified in something in tech, but I don't want to waste my time on something that's not going to be in demand. Well, have you looked into what courses are really in demand? There are some areas that are continuing to grow based on data, based on what employers are hiring for. Okay, well, can you at least give me some of the top certifications so I know where to focus in on? All right, well, I'll help you a little bit. Let me show you what's in demand. Perfect. Coming in at number 10 is a course by Google. This course is Cloud Digital Leader. It's not necessarily a technical course, so whether you are on the business side or technical side, there is a lot you can gain from this course. So what exactly does this course entail? A cloud digital leader articulates the capabilities of Google's cloud core products and services and how they can benefit organizations. So this isn't a certification just to take if you are someone looking to work at Google, but it's a certification to take if you're interested in getting into the cloud space, if you're interested in working with cloud. Here are the four main areas that this exam will test you on. One being digital transformation with cloud, infrastructure and application modernization, and innovating with data and Google Cloud. Also to the last one being security and operations. This is something that even if you end up working on an Amazon product or anything like that, having the basis and certification of a cloud product is really important in today's day and age. And according to PC Magazine, the average salary for someone who has this certification is $142,000. So this certification is relatively new. It launched back in 2021, but it's already continuing to see demand grow for it. Coming in at number 9 is Microsoft certification. This one is Azure Solutions Architect Specialist. This is an exam that I'm sure you've heard about from past years. It's something that is extremely popular. And why is it not higher on the list, Tiff? Well, I guess we'll get to that as we get closer. You'll understand what are really trending for number 3, number 2, number 1. But for now, this is at number 9. It's still very in demand, and it's one of those things that when I was making this list, I really had to be careful because it's all dependent. It's dependent on what area you really want to focus on, how you're growing your career. But overall, we're ranking at number 9. This exam is designed to certify professionals with advanced experience designing cloud and other hybrid solutions on the Microsoft Azure platform. And the compensation for this is relatively on the low side compared to others on this list, on the average of $142,000. And this is according to Skillsoft Research. Coming in at number 8 is Certified Ethical Hacker. This course really intrigues me anyways. You keep on hearing about cybersecurity, it's so in demand, and it's going to continue in that direction. Now, listen, I gotta be honest, this course isn't necessarily cheap, so it is a bit of an investment. I would say if you are someone who is looking into this course, to really consider it if you are already working at a company, and hopefully you can get them to help with funding it. The goal of this course is to help you master ethical hacking. And some of the skills that you will learn include penetration testing, and it delivers an in-demand ethical hacking skills while preparing you for internationally recognized certified ethical hacker certification exam. So I really like that this certification will help prepare you for the next level of the exam. So this is more so a course, and it's help preparing you for the certified ethical hacker exam, which is extremely in demand. I mean, the stats around cybersecurity and jobs needed are honestly mind-blowing. I'll include some on screen here, but as you can see, it's an area that if you are looking to really have a long-term career solidified, go in cybersecurity. There is so much demand for jobs, both technical and non-technical, and it will continue to increase this way as everything continues to go online. Coming in at number 7, you knew something had to be AI related on here, which is IBM's AI Engineering Professional Certificate. This is a course that I personally have looked into a lot and I'm really considering taking as the world of AI continues to grow so quickly. This is ranked number 7 this year on the list, but I have a feeling that next year it might even be higher and so on. This is a great course to take. I am pulling up on screen here. It is available on Coursera, it is free, and what it will teach you is to describe machine learning, deep learning, neural networks, and other machine learning algorithms like classification, etc. Once you have completed this course, not only will you have a strong understanding of the business side of AI, but also too, you will actually get to build deep learning models and use tools like PyTorch or TensorFlow. Now, it wouldn't be a full list if we didn't list some AWS courses on here or certifications on here. It's an area that as a whole is not only in demand currently, but going to continue to be in demand. It's kind of the gold standard when it comes to certifications. Companies always look at that and go, okay, you put in a lot of time, you put in a lot of effort, you must have a lot of knowledge on this. So for number six with AWS comes Solutions Architect, and this specifically is the Associate's certification. This course will really test you on your expertise in designing systems on the AWS Services Cloud. I really enjoy their courses and what they have to, or certifications and what they have to offer, because not only is it a lot of reading and education on that side, but also too, it's implementation. A lot of these courses, you actually have to get in there and utilize the tools that they are speaking about. And according, once again, to PC Magazine, architects can make an average of around $155,000 per year. Coming in at number five is CISSP, stands for Certified Information System Security Professional. So this is great for you if you are interested in working in security analysis, auditing, systems engineering, or really anything in between. And this is something that I had trouble placing, because as cybersecurity becomes more important, I wanted to put it higher on the list, but there are other ones that we will get to which overtake it in many ways, which you'll see. But this is a great certification. It's recognized across the industry. It's a pretty intense exam and certification to go through. But if you are really interested in the systems engineering side of things, this is a course to really look into. Also, with this certification, it's important to note you will still need education or continuing education after you complete it. Each year, you will need to maintain your credentials even after getting the certification. This holds it to really high standards to ensure that individuals who say they have the certification, who have completed this course, are really up to date with industry best practices. Now, next up is a certification that does not require technical skills. However, I see a lot of software engineers growing their career in this direction. Can you guess what it is? Project management. And I know some of you are either for project managers, we love them. Others of you are probably like, I haven't had a great experience with them, I don't really love them. But regardless, they are a very vital and key part or key aspect in having a business running properly. So the Project Management Professional, or PMP certification, has been around for quite a while, evolving and updating its course over time to be relevant, but it's something that is well recognized in the industry. Now, once again, this is not a free certification, so I would really recommend asking your employer if they can help support funding it. I mean, at the end of the day, your employer wants you to stay with them, to grow with them, and also too, if you are showing that you're taking initiative to learn other skills, it should be almost looked at as a win-win. They are funding for more education, and in turn, you can apply that to the company. This is a certification for individuals who really want to expand their skills as project managers. The certification shows that an individual has the skills to define, plan, and manage complex projects and teams. And the average salary for a PMP certified individual is around $150,000 US. Coming in at number three is something for all my DevOps people, which is Microsoft Azure DevOps Engineer. This is a great certification. It's been around for a while, and they continue to update it as the world of DevOps evolves. Don't die, it's gonna die again. Also, it's important to know that this is a course that you already have to have experience with developing in Azure, and also to be familiar with Azure DevOps and GitHub. There are prerequisites of two other certifications before you get to this, so that's why it is relatively high up on this list, is because it is very high paying and also too very in demand. For number two on the list is CISM, Certified Information Security Manager. And this, of course, is a really well-paid certification. You are getting into management level here. It's definitely something, if you are earlier on in your career, to strive for. At this level, with this certification, it really focuses more on a management level. So it's designed to really have education and an understanding for engineering security protocols and to be able to manage a company's overall IT security. As a CISM individual, you'll have access lines of business. You will be in charge of the company you are working at, IT's department for security. So this is probably, it's a massive role when you think about all the responsibility that really falls under it. And of course, they are very well paid. Soft Skills says you can make an average of $162,000 per year on average. So some people make much higher, some people make lower. Coming in at number one is AWS Solutions Architect, but the professional certification. We spoke earlier in this list of the associate one, and now we're talking about the professional. This is an extremely high paying certification, starting in around or averaging around $168,000 US. And this is an exam that, no, we cannot just start working in tech and start taking. We do have to have experience. At least 2 years of experience working with AWS is required. You must know one scripting language, have expertise with AWS APIs, and also to be familiar with both Linux and Windows. So this is a course that if you're already on this path, that I would highly suggest you looking into taking. And if you're just starting your career, definitely look at how you can structure your career based on these exams and really work your way up. All right, those are the top 10 certifications in tech for 2023. This list, as I mentioned at the beginning, was really based on a lot of different lists on trends I saw throughout the list, and then also too, trying to keep it a bit diverse that no matter if you are coming from a technical or non-technical background, there is a certification in here for you. I think though, throughout this list, one thing you will see is really a trend between two areas, one being cloud and the other being cybersecurity. These are two areas that, based on data, based on numbers, are really growing, and jobs are so in demand in these two areas. So if you are looking for an area to really focus your energy and expertise on, these are two that I'd really check out. All right, thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. List down below some other certifications that maybe weren't included in this video. I'm always curious to hear what you are working on. Also, give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. All right, I'll see you all soon.